Good evening, and welcome to the lighting of our Advent wreath for the fourth week of Advent, and this is our final gathering at our Advent wreath. As we begin this evening, I'd like to ask you to take a moment for all of us to remember who we are and whose we are. And in this, the fourth week of Advent, we celebrate the women. So I ask you to join me in praying to the woman who bore the Son of God. And we will pray the first half of the Hail Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Our reading this evening is taken from the Gospel of Luke, the first chapter. At that time, Mary got ready and hurried to a town in the hill country of Judea, where she entered Zechariah's home and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the baby leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. In a loud voice, she exclaimed, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the child you will bear. But why am I so favored that the mother of my Lord should come to me? As soon as the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the baby in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed is she who has believed that the Lord would fulfill his promises to her." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. I am sure many of you were wondering, when is she going to get to the women? Well, here we are. But first, I'd like to tell you a story. This is a story of a little girl I know. And what she really wanted for Christmas were furry slipper boots. And I promised her that she would get them. Well, I didn't get to visit her family until later in the day on Christmas. And when I arrived, I had my box all wrapped up, beautiful. She dove into that box. She was sure what was in there. She opened them up, took out the slippers, put them on, danced all around. And then her mother said to her, "Okay, take them off, and you can put them on again later when it's time to go to bed." She took them off, but she forgot to put them back in the box. And along came the puppy. And the puppy saw this furry thing sitting on the floor and went, "Wow, stuffed animal," grabbed it and took off. Well, the craziness began. We all chased the puppy around the house, who was having a wonderful time, and my friend wound up in the kitchen in tears, and she said to me, "I just wanted it to be a perfect Christmas." Well, as we all know, that is not real. Real is confusing, full of contradictions, and kind of crazy. I know one year at a holiday meal, we had turned the heat up in our house very high because my mother was coming and she felt the cold. Even when it was 80 degrees, she was cold. So, arrives my niece and her then boyfriend, and he comes in a long, floor-length, black leather coat. and never took it off. Now, we're sitting at the dinner table, and my mother, never known for, let's say, not speaking her mind, said to him, "Are you cold?" Meanwhile, we were all sweating, and he goes, "No." "Well, are you going to take off your coat?" He said, "No, I like my coat." So my mother goes, "Whatever floats your boat." She went on eating her dinner, and we all just kind of sat back a little bit and rolled our eyes, you know? We all have these things, don't we? Well, let's be real about the gospel here. This scene looks beautiful and calm, doesn't it? But I think it calls us to take a closer human look. I call this story the meeting of the moms. One probably had morning sickness, and the other one for sure had swollen ankles. Neither one of them were feeling quite their best at that time. Mary, an unwed young girl, was pregnant, and she had traveled over 80 miles, probably on foot. There was no Uber. Could you see an Uber camel? Wouldn't that be fun? I just thought of that. Or an Uber donkey. Hey. But, so we have her, then we have Elizabeth. Now, Elizabeth is the wife of a priest, and he is the presiding priest that year. And his old wife is pregnant. Now, those of us who are women, we know that women are known to gossip. I think some men are known to gossip too, but okay, we'll stay with the women. And here's this older woman, pregnant. I'm sure there were a lot of conversations about that. But she was shut away in the home, in Zachariah's home, as was the custom for women who were pregnant. These two women, one very young, and I'm not so sure how old the other one was. I know for sure she was not as old as me. She might have been 40 or 45. But they needed each other. And I do find amazing that through it all, Zachariah, as you can remember, was mute. He couldn't speak. He couldn't speak until after his baby, John the Baptist, was born. Now, from the outside, doesn't this look like a rather absurd story? Doesn't it look like something that could arrive in your living room or mine? You know? And really, it was a blessing. Because a blessing is when God is present. It shows us God present, a blessing. And I think that is why we celebrate these women on the very last Sunday of Advent, when we are all a little crazy. Right now, I know things seem a bit crazier than we had expected. And for parents, right now, the shipping problems have added to some stress, particularly if you wanted to buy a mixie. I'm not really sure what a mixie is, but I heard it on the news. And all I could think of was, I'm old enough to remember, Cabbage Patch dolls. And people going crazy for them. And one father even flying to London to buy the doll. I can assure you that was not my father. Hey. But all of this, I believe all of the craziness, everything that we experience, today is called Super Saturday. If you haven't shopped by now, give a gift card. Hey, don't do this to yourself. But some people love it. They love the craziness of it all. So, we're out, we're crazy, we're going online, we got to get this, we got to get that. Is this the right thing? Maybe I should return it and get something else. All crazy. I believe, for myself, it is all an indication of something much deeper within us. It is not the Christmas card image. I believe what it stands for is within all people a desire, a longing that people felt for ages, for God to come, for God to come in their own time, for God to come in our own time. Waiting for God on that first Christmas and every Christmas after that, waiting for God to come anew, anew. Advent is a time of remembering the desire, of remembering that longing. People don't talk about it, but I know it's in your soul, because I have spoken and listened to a number of you over the years. I know your longing. I know your desire for more, your desire for deep peace. Pope Francis calls Christmas the feast of the encounter. God's love come among us. And he tells us, God's love is not a vague, it's not vague at all. God's love has a name and a face, and it is Jesus. Both Mary and Elizabeth had this encounter in the gospel story I just read. They both had a recognition of the presence of God. And Elizabeth's reaction to Mary says it all. The child in my womb leapt for joy. They both knew the encounter. And yet, in reality, they both had to keep doing, didn't they? They both had to keep doing life, keep living life. Mary, if you think about it, she even had to go back to Nazareth, the 80 miles. And then shortly after that, we find her on her way to Jerusalem. And she gets as far as Bethlehem, from where Joseph's family came from. No wonder she needed a donkey for the part of the ride. My goodness, did she need a donkey, eh? But someplace in our lives, I think we have all had a moment of encounter. A moment of encounter. I remember making my first communion. And in our church, we had a little old country church. And they opened the gates of the altar rail. I don't know how many of you are old enough to remember an altar rail, but there were gates, and they opened the gates. And the First Communion kids went in, and we knelt on the steps right in front of the altar. Wow. Talk about the encounter with mystery and the holy right in that moment. And so many of us felt it. And I do believe that we are trying each in our own way to recapture that specialness, that touch. We can't do that because we need to encounter Jesus in this time. This time of uncertainty, this time of COVID, this time of family stuff. Everybody's got the family stuff, don't you? This time of the stuff that goes on. But I got a lot of responses today to the daily Advent quote. And so many people said, this says it all. And when I reread it, I said, this does say it all. The time we're in. Now, don't cry over the past, it's gone. Don't stress about the future, it hasn't arrived yet. Live in the present and make it beautiful. Beautiful. Life is not a holy card. My life's never been a holy card. Life is messy. There's lots of contradictions. Lots of confusion. I was talking to somebody on the phone today, and I said to them, I'll say it to you all, right outside this area is all the rest of our Christmas stuff, right? It's kind of there, ready, waiting. But we all have it, don't we? We all have it. It's the stuff. So, how do we hold on to our memories and await the new ways that Jesus wants to encounter us this Christmas? Well, I have a thought on that. My thought is awareness. That we keep aware of how God is present in each day. And let that be, that type of awareness be a background to our day. You know, from the shower, to the car, to the gatherings, that be there in our mind. Because the secret seems to be where you are now. Be where you find yourself. That's where the encounter is. Where we find ourselves in that moment. A few years ago, I brought a priest friend of mine who was suffering from dementia to a nursing home to visit one of our sisters who was there. She was struggling and had a hard time, and she was very lonely. And I thought, well, let me bring him there and see how it goes. We went in, and they started to talk, and the moment was transformed. He became, once again, a minister of peace, and she was open. I just stood back, said nothing, and watched. And you could feel the blessing. God present right there in that encounter. Awareness. Keep your eyes and ears open to the moments. Don't brush them by. Because God is coming. And we, like Mary and Elizabeth, we need each other to help us remember. Who are the people who help you remember? Maybe it's time to thank them this Christmas. Today's Advent journey is the same as the journey was for these moms we celebrate tonight, the meetings of the moms. The people we meet, the unexpected events and places we find ourselves, these are all the moments that we discover our Bethlehem, where Jesus is born in our hearts. And don't worry, God never tires of enticing us. God never tires of drawing us in subtle ways to find where Bethlehem is in our lives right now. Don't miss the encounter, even if it might be in a chase around the house after a slightly chewed and very wet fuzzy slipper. God is near. We celebrate. And I ask you to join me in praying Mary's response to God as seen through the eyes of a monk after a year in solitude. My soul magnifies the Lord. My spirit delights in God, my Savior, for you have blessed me lavishly and make me ready to respond. You shatter my little world and let me be poor before you. You take from me all my plans and you give me more than I can hope for. You give me opportunity and the ability to become free and to burst through my boundaries. You give me the strength to become daring, to build on you alone. For you show yourself as the ever greater one in my life. You have made known to me this, that it is in my being servant that it becomes possible for your kingdom to burst through here and now. Amen.
Mercy on my loneliness.
every time I hear that song, it kind of brings tears to my eyes. Isn't it touching? That's by John Michael Talbert, and the name of the song is Holy Is His Name. And I came back to you this evening because this is our last gathering before Christmas, partly because we need to clear the Advent wreath away to make room for the baby Jesus, and also because our first Advent candle is going out, which goes to show, don't save the candles year to year. But they were expensive, and I thought, well, they look pretty good. So we have to end Advent this week. I think God has other reasons for ending Advent this week. But I want to wish you and your family a great season of peace and health. Oh my gosh, for health. But a number of you have written to me and said, could we please see your window? And then some other people wrote and said, could we please see your dog? So tonight you get to see both, because the dog is right next to me. First the window. Okay, this is our window. And are you ready for this? Let's see if we can see her. Where is she? Well, you really can't see her because it's kind of dark. In that fuzz over there is our dog. Hey, she's a little golden retriever and her name is Lindsay. And she has some special needs. And she's a very good girl. And it's, of course, it asks a great deal of patience from Lindsay and from us. And it's a blessing to have her. So I will be doing some other programs in the new year. And you will be hearing about them after the new year. I did want to take this opportunity to thank those of you who sent me a card and a gift for Christmas. It certainly helps during the winter months to have your donations along the way when it's a little tighter and we don't do as much. And in this season when there's no possibility of seeing you in person, and I really do wish there was a possibility of seeing you in person. I will try to do a few things on Zoom. At least I can see your faces then. Right now, this past 4 weeks, I've been just looking at myself, which is always a little trip, you know? But have fun. Don't take yourself so seriously. Enjoy the children in your life. And if you don't have any children right now, right in your own family, right now, in all the stores, are little dolls and little trucks that need a home. Why not drop them off someplace that they would be most welcome? Because all the children belong to all of us. And our Jesus was a little child. And this Christmas, we celebrate that. And we also celebrate that he is here now among us. Have a wonderful Christmas. Enjoy every moment of it.